In this video, let's see one of the most important process of Oracle GoldenGate, that is extract. So as you see in the diagram, after we are done with the preparation of environment, that is after we are done with the prerequisites that needs to be done on the source and target databases, we will be capturing our extract process. So what does your extract process do? The extract process, it captures the data from the transactional logs, that is your redo log files if it is an Oracle database. So extract process captures the data from the transactional logs, puts it into a trial file, and then you have a secondary extract process known as data pump process. So this is a primary extract process which captures the data from the redo log files, puts it into a trial file. There is a secondary optional extract process known as data pump process, which takes the trial file, which takes your local trial file and passes it on to the remote database, that is your target database known as remote trial file to the replicat site. So now we will be seeing what are the different parameters that we use while setting up the extract process. As you see the overview, extract process, it captures all the changes that are made to the database. Whatever changes that are made to the database goes to your redo log files, and your extract process reads those redo log files and it copies the data, that is the change data, and puts it into a local trial file. Not only that, what are the other ways in which you can configure the extract? Extract, as I said, it captures the data from the redo log files. It can also capture the data from the JMS, that is nothing but Java messaging services. You can have your JMS queues configured, and extract can capture the data from the JMS as well. And it can also capture the data directly from the source tables. This capturing of data directly from the source table of your source database is needed when you are doing the initial load. What do you mean by initial load? Initial load is nothing but bringing your target database in sync with that of your source database. So in that case, your extract can directly read the data from the source tables and put it into the target database. And you can also write the data to the trial files. As I said, you can capture the data, extract can capture the data, put it into the trial file, and the same trial file is read by your secondary extract process known as data pump process. So whenever a transaction is committed, extract captures the data, puts it into a trial file, and your secondary extract process captures the trial file and sends it to the target site. As you see, this is the example. For example, if you want to create an extract file known as finance, so you need to give edit params finance. It is going to create an extract file known as finance, and then this is what the parameters that you will be passing. So first, extract and the extract name, followed by user ID and the password. This is the user ID that we have created for the GoldenGate purpose at the database level, right? So you are going to give that user ID and password. Then you are going to give the local trial file. So your primary extract captures the data, puts it into a trial file. So that trial file is known as local trial file, which is in this location. So it is there in GGS DIR DAT location, which is nothing but your local trial file. And what is that you are capturing? You are capturing two tables, namely orders and inventory, which belongs to the sales user. So you are basically extracting the data, not all the data of the database, but only data that is related to these two tables, that is orders and inventory, and putting that data into this extrial, which is nothing but your local trial file. So this is how your extract is configured. So once after your extract is configured, you are going to register that extract. So add extract extract name, tran log, begin now. What does this do? It is going to register your extract and starts capturing the data immediately. That is what is your tran log begin now does. And then you are going to register your trial file as well using add extrial. So whatever is the trial file that you have given in the parameter file, which is extrial ggs dir dat 1t. So this 1t is the starting name of your trial file, and then it will be appended with the sequence number, say 1, 2, 3 in the increasing order. So you are again registering your trial files using add extrial. So whatever is the trial file location that you have mentioned in the parameter file, the same trial file location you need to mention here along with the extract name. So once you have registered the extract and the trial files, you are ready to start the extract process, that is start extract extract name. In the next slide, we are seeing what are the different examples. So add extract, extract name, tranlog begin now, as I said, is nothing but it's immediately capturing the data from the transaction logs. So once you register the extract and start the extract by registering it, it will start immediately capturing the data from the extract files. And then if you want to start the extract at a previous time, then you can also give begin and the timestamp. If you do not want to capture the data immediately, but you want to capture the data from the previous timestamp, that also you can do by using add extract tranlog begin. And if you are configuring your secondary extract process known as your data pump process, which is an optional process, then you can even register that using add extract the data pump name, that is your pump process. What is the source for your pump process? The source for your data pump extract process is nothing but the trial file that has been created by your primary extract, right? So that is what you are doing when you are creating the data pump process, which we'll be seeing in the next video. Your source for the data pump process is nothing but the trial files that is created by your primary extract. And finally, you can also create a temporary extract, in this case known as load, which is using the table. That means your extract process will fetch the data from the source table and replicate it to the target database. For example, if you have a target database which is not having any data and you want to do the initial load on this database, that means you want to get your target database in sync with your source database, then you can use your extract initial load process, that is add extract extract name sources table. That means it will fetch the data directly from the tables of your source database and put it into the target database using this command, which is basically used for the initial load.